Yes, welcome to Emperor Pongzu. I'm Vicky for IU, and this evening we will learn the different family of the animal that we have here in the zoo. So what are we waiting for? Let's begin with the reptile. First reptile we have the blue tongue skink. Blue tongue skink come all the way from the Australia and Asia. And you know where the blue tongue skink get their name? From their very blue tongue. So they are reptile, means they are cold-blooded. This animal cannot regulate their body temperature, so they are will lie out on the rock or try to expose area under the sun to get their or raise their body temperature. But if the temperature comes drop, this animal becomes sluggish and go into a state non-torpor, where they will lose their appetite or they will not eat. That's why this animal will go out and then expose the body under the sun to get their appetite back. This is Robin. Next, we have the royal ball python, Mara. It's pretty easy to see where Mara get their name. I mean the ball python. Because they are this snake spends most of their day for up into a ball. And they are non-venomous. So they use basically one big muscle to subdue or overpower their prey until suffocate. And these snakes found in the North and West Africa. They have incredible sense of smell. The nose called the Jacobson organ. And that organ have a tooth that come up from the mouth that reaches to the roof of the snake's mouth. This is Mara. Last, we have the African sport tortoise named Tommy. So this tortoise is the large tortoise in the Africa and the third large in the world because they are so much growing after their lifetime. And tortoise shell is more than its home. The shell is connected to the spine and consists two parts, the top one we call that carapace, and the bottom that known as the plastron, and that connects to the side that we call that brain. And the shell have a strong concentrate with the keratin, like same we have in our fingernail and our hair. They also have a protein and the calcium. So everybody, this is Tommy. And we have our reptile here, Tommy, Robin, and the bullfighter, Mara. Everybody, give a big round of applause for the reptile. Next, zoo is the home to the stars of all the wild animals. Like what, the wild animal? Yes, tiger. What again? Lion, elephant, the tall one, giraffe, and then colorful parrots, and cheetah, bear. We also have the farm little yard. Well, we have the great little farm yard filled with the domesticated animals like chickens, sheep, and goats in the town. So here we have a group of the baby goats. They eat their early dinner. As I close to you, I will pick a volunteer to help me to feed the baby goat. Why you get so scary? Let's join to feed the baby goat. Feed the baby goat. Baby! Come. Let's go. No, you're too small. Let's go. Why no? My goodness. Why scary? Come on, mom. Feed the baby goat. You will regret if you are not there. Yes, come on. Oh, no, that's too small. No. You can. Okay, you mom. Come. Tommy. Let's go. Okay, daddy, go. Okay, the security. Let's go. Let's go. It's okay. Trainer will assist you too. Or maybe mommy. Don't bring your ice cream. The goats not eat ice cream. Let's go. Okay, two people listen up. Yallah. Come on. See, you will regret. is so much fun. Come on, let's go follow Tren Omaru. Now because you only two, I will choose your color. So stand behind this amp. Behind, yes, behind. Click translate Tren Omaru. Do your job. You hear? Okay. So now Tren Omaru will give the food, milk, salad. Later, the baby goat will come from that side, that gate. Come and then stand here, okay? They will only focus with your bottle, with food on your hand. So don't be scary, just stay where you are. Okay, don't be scary. Are you ready? Okay, let's go the baby goat! Where is the baby? Wow, we have Stone, Sam, Bumble, and Morgan. Why are you kicking me? Yes, just use this food also. See, that's so having fun. We are here having fun. If your bottle finished, give the bottle. It's okay. Give the food to the black one. Yeah, it's okay. Okay. Let's go, it's finished. There is no food anymore. Come on, let's go. Yeah, Taras. Let's go. They will follow you. Do you know what the baby goats call? They call a kids, and they are incredible intelligence, so you can train them to do a variety behavior. Before that, I will ask the volunteer. Are you happy? Yes, of course. You have a great experience here in Everpark Zoo for free feeding the baby goat. Give a big round of applause for the volunteer. Next, we will. What a sound! Can you recover the sound? Snake? No, not snake. What is that? Yes, the rattling sound from the porcupine. Please welcome the Indian crested porcupine. Name Spine.
Spine.
Do you know what is the porcupine? Do you know? Yes, you were right, yes. So they are the Labrador, have a coat with the sharp spine or quill. So that quill, that white one, make a rattling sound to protect them against the predator. Contrary to believe that porcupine not shoot the quill, but they are, not shoot the quill, but they are detach the quill. So when the predator try to pounce or bite them, they will detach their quill. Porcupine are herbivore, means they are eat chicken. No, they are eat shoot and root, and most of them feed on the plant. Porcupine have a 20 permanent teeth, the front teeth known as incisor, and that constantly growing into their lifetime. And the incisor is designed to gnawing and cutting the plant's material like the twigs, bars, and leaves. So do you ever see porcupine on the show? No, yes, right now. Right now, yeah? And next, the unique fact about the porcupine, they have important role in our ecosystem. You know what that role? No. They are as engineer of the ecosystem. So porcupines help to clean surrounding by eating the human waste, like everything that we throw, and eating the dry leaves. Oh yeah. So everybody give a big round of applause for our Indian crested porcupine named Spine. Oh, Spine wants to have enjoying. Bye bye, Spot. Time to back home. Now I will share to you the sad story that we have here in Emory Park Zoo. So long time ago, someone brought the dog to the veterinary clinic center and had injured on his leg because the dog got a car accident. So the vet in the veterinary clinic center do everything that they can do to help the dog. And then the dog recovery, during the recovery, the owner of the dog need to leave this country. The dog and the owner have felt deeply sad because they need to separate. And we are here, the trainer and zookeeper walk together to help the dog, give the training to stimulate them, the dog mind up, and to keep the dog physically strong. So, everybody, do you want to see the dog? Yes! Oh yes, finally come from there. Here, Oliver! Let's see what Oliver can do. I I'm just so happy. Yes, the keeper here.
I would like to say thank you for assisting. Enjoy your job and have a good day.
Yes, everybody. Thank you so much for watching the Mix Animal presentation.